too, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Tell me how to keep my world moving on without you, yeah. Yeah, yeah. How can my world be much better off without you? You on the inside looking out, wanted to be like they can't get back home. Mom says crying for the both of them, holding on to pictures cause she can't hold.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. On today's video, we are doing another wine tasting. We are in Beau Constantia. There's two Constantia wine farms. I think there's Groot Constantia and then Beau Constantia. So I've been to Groot Constantia before. Today we are at the Beau Constantia. And if it is your first time on this channel, welcome. And if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back, darling. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe. Also, like, how cute is my hairstyle, you guys? I absolutely love it. Love my hairstyle. If you would like me to show you some different hairstyles that I do with my natural hair, comment down below and I will make a video for you guys with different hairstyles that I like to do for my natural hair. I absolutely love it.
With every passing moment, thoughts of you run through my head. I am slowly realizing I think you're truly heaven sent. I think you're truly something special.
So it's almost like a no-name bottle with our beard on it. The beard is our old winemaker's beard. Yeah, he was quite a shy guy. I didn't like people knowing his name. So Parano without name and then his beard.
But great, thank you.
What is it?
I love this glass, you guys. Look at this glass.
It is a 66% Chenin-based blend. Then have your Fernand Perez, Rosone, Verdello, and a little bit of Viognier. Fernand Perez is a Portuguese grape recently planted in South Africa. It's going to bring subtle notes of ginger and lemongrass to the wine. Overall, it does have a thicker mouthfeel, purely because each individual varietal has been matured or fermented on the skin stems and then matured in French oak, so it's exactly the same way you make red. That's why it's got that thicker mouthfeel to it. Perfect balance between rich and acidity. It's just a very different kind of months for the second fill. Quite a young wine, so quite easy drinking on the palate. Slightly almost buttery, you could say. It really does express a youthfulness with that like Cabernet Franc bringing in your more floral notes, that tiny bit of Cab Sauv bringing in the beautiful volume structure that you kind of look for in a red. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Give me the glass. White pepper and clove as well. It's a very complex one, so a lot of different things to make it. Great, enjoy.
Thank you.
Hey guys, so we are done with the wine tasting. It was absolutely beautiful, like sure, in terms of the views and the aesthetics, definitely a 10 out of 10. The place is gorgeous, as you can see behind me, like the views are giving, it's legit like 10 out of 10. And then in terms of the wines that we tasted, I would say an 8 out of 10. Their MCC was really, really good. The first one that we tasted was really good, and then the white wine as well was very nice. The third one wasn't so nice, and then the last wine, the fourth one, the blend was, the red blend was amazing. I love white red wine, so the blend was top. So I'll say an 8, 9 out of 10. And then in terms of price, it was very affordable. I'd say we went for the one, I think it was like 140 per person, so I mean for less than 200 rand or less than 150, you're getting spectacular views, you're getting amazing wine. And then we ordered a cheese platter on the side. That one was a bit like more pricey, I think it was about 300, but in terms of pricing, I'd say also 10 out of 10. I would definitely recommend you to come and check it out. Yeah, like I said, it's Beau Constantia and it was lovely. That is it for this vlog, and if you have not subscribed by now, please subscribe, and I will see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.